About a year and a half ago, Vario sent me a prototype of their Empire Art Deco watch. Which, if you haven't seen, go check it out. It's one I liked enough that I eventually bought. But along with that watch, they sent one of the craziest straps I've ever seen. It was this rather fuzzy wool strap. And I think this particular one was called the Oatmeal Colorway, which is mostly gray with some brown and blue hues to it. And I think it's safe to say that I'd never seen anything quite like it before, and I haven't since. Now, I was surprised to learn that it's one of Vario's signature strap lines, and it was actually made from genuine Harris tweed wool. And as odd as the idea was, I was kind of fascinated by it. Eventually, that strap was going to go on to another reviewer along with the prototype, but while I had it, I had to try it on a number of other watches. And for whatever reason, I just loved how it looked on my Champagne Khaki King. Now, a few months ago, I got an email from Ivan, who runs Vario, and he wanted to let me know that they had a new type of Harris tweed strap. This time it had a herringbone pattern to it. And he wanted to know if he could give me a couple to review. Now, of course, with everything going on, there were some shipping delays, but they eventually did show up, and here we are. So as soon as I got them, I started trying them on a whole variety of watches. So first off, I think it's going to be obvious that these straps aren't going to be for everyone, especially if you're more of a traditionalist when it comes to your watches. They are quality straps, and if you're wondering whether or not you'd like these, just kind of go with your gut instincts and first reaction when you see them here. The big reason I like them is just because they're so unique, and I love how they really shake up the look on certain watches. Now, on a good-looking watch, I think they can take it to a different level, but even on something simple like a classic field watch, or even something very casual like this Mickey, I think it makes you stop and just take a second look. But once again, these aren't going to be for everyone, or for every type of watch. Some people just freak out when they see leather on a diver. And with this, I think their head might actually explode. The second thing is price. At $40, they're more in that mid to premium strap category. And I think they are worth it when you compare them to other straps in the same price range. Not just from the quality, but also the uniqueness of them. And if you're not familiar with Harris Tweed, just kind of Google it. But the short version is that it's a high quality Scottish wool with just strict requirements on where and who can make it. As well as there is a certification process, which does allow the products to be stamped as genuine Harris Tweed. So there are currently four different colorways of this herringbone pattern, and I believe this is the Rolling Smoke strap, while this one is the pistachio version. And here you can see how the new versions on the right compare to the originals. And I think they're just a bit more tidy with that herringbone pattern. Now, the other big difference is in the keepers, as the original ones are made of wool, while the new herringbone ones are made of a rustic piece of leather. And I really like the look and the feel of the new versions. On the original, that wool keeper was the only piece of wool that was touching your wrist, and it could get itchy at times. Even though the top here has this nice, tight, yet always fuzzy weave of wool, as I said, it won't be itchy at all on your wrist, as there is a nice piece of leather sitting between that and the wool. Now, of course, they do have multiple sizes, but these are the 20mm versions, which start at 20mm near the watch and then taper down more to 18 at the buckle, which I think streamlines the look and makes them a little more comfortable. The straps are a little stiff at first, but they break in nicely pretty quickly. And once they do, they're pretty comfortable to wear. And I think they're actually more breathable than your standard leather strap of this size, as again, you only have that thin piece of leather, and then you get to the wool, which is actually quite breathable. In fact, while wool may sound like an unconventional material to make a strap out of, it has a number of properties that actually make it a good choice. It's breathable, moisture wicking, and has pretty good water resistance as well. Although, I still wouldn't get these too wet, just because the leather underneath might not. The only major downside I found to these straps are that they are a bit short. If you want to get specific, the site does list the lengths of each side, but I can tell you that on my 7-inch wrist, I was using the third to last hole. So if you do have larger wrists, these probably aren't going to work for you. Now, putting these straps on a dress watch is the obvious choice, and I think you can even take something inexpensive like this Orient 3-star, and really make it something special. Yet as weird as it may sound, I think my favorite combinations were on my nicer field watches, just like the Khaki King and the Alpinist. In fact, I really loved how this rolling smoke strap looked on the Alpinist. It was by far my favorite of all these combinations, as it really shows off why I love the versatility of these dressy field watches, where you can throw a strap like this on it, and I think it could easily fill in for a dress watch in a pinch. Now, on a dress watch, I leave this strap on permanently, but on those field watches, I'd still have something more casual. But having the ability to swap something like this on it is really nice, especially when you're traveling. Unless you're going to go full formal, I think something like this could work, and it's one less watch to bring with you. So, just to sum it all up, even though these aren't straps that I would wear all the time on every single watch, I still really like them. And at $40, they aren't an inexpensive purchase, but I can tell you that the quality is there, and they are really comfortable to wear. Not to mention, one of the most unique types of straps I've ever found, and that's both a strength and a weakness, which all depends on how much you want your watch to stand out. Now, currently there are 4 different colorways for this new Harris Tweed version, but there are a number of those originals. So if you're curious, just go over to Vario and check them out. Now as always, let me know in the comments what you think about these straps and these combinations. And if you really want to know what that dive watch looks like with one of these on it, I'll have a link to my Instagram down below. So, as always, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe down below. Thanks for watching.